Hey guys, how's it going today? Look, you know, we've all been wondering this. We're like, Hero Academia, for those of you who don't know, I don't know how you cannot know. My Hero Academia Season 4 is coming out on October 12th, 2019, guys. Given that, we need to figure out what's going on with Deku's father. So Horikoshi stated during the San Diego Comic-Con 2018 that Deku's father will be revealed in the future. Which leads us to the most important thing ever. Who is Deku's father? I went to forums, I went to Reddit, I went to different YouTube videos, I went to different blogs, and I basically compiled all the facts that I think could help us figure out who it's going to be. Now, this theory and the hypothesis right now that I think it is that All For One is Izuku Midoriya's father. And we're gonna start with the fact that we all know that Horikoshi is a big fan of Star Wars, right? First number of facts. The parallels between Star Wars and My Hero Academia. So first off, look at this picture. Look at how closely Ojiro's outfit is based off of Luke Skywalker's outfit. Look at this comparison between Darth Vader and All For One right now. Horikoshi likes to name tons of different locations of the same name as places or things as Star Wars, like Kamino or Dagobah, where Luke's training with Yoda takes place in Star Wars.
All right, I'll give it a try.
No, try not. Do. Or do not. There is no try.
And in My Hero Academia, Dagobah Municipal Beach Park?
Hey, it's pretty comfy up on this bridge. How are you doing down there?
For example, Kamino in Star Wars was an aquatic planet apparently located south of the Rishi Maze in an extra-galactic star system.
Clones can think creatively. You will find that they are immensely superior to droids.
Now, in My Hero Academia, they called the incident when they kidnapped Bakugo and his rescue the Kamino incident, because it took place in the Kamino Ward.
No way are those all Nomu.
And since Horikoshi's such a big fan of Star Wars, My Hero Academia's plotline and story writing is bound to have been influenced by Star Wars. For example, like, you know, when you have your idols and you have people you look up to, you start copying them initially, or you start taking things that you like about them, their personality, their quirks. Quirks, get it? Their, you know, parts of their characteristics, and you start embodying them yourself. So without a shadow of a doubt, the fact that you like something, you're gonna be influenced by it, and hence, you know, there's gonna be some definite influence of Star Wars, which is really apparent. Number one, Luke Skywalker starts off as a nobody. No one knows who he is or even cares for that matter, just like Deku. But he has a strong sense of justice and he also has a passion for his hobbies, just like Midoriya. Number two, Obi-Wan shows up and eventually trains Luke Skywalker in the ways of the Jedi. Kinda like how All Might shows up and trains Midoriya. Number three, this training though, for Luke Skywalker isn't enough. Then he eventually trains with Yoda on Dagobah. Kinda like how Midoriya goes and trains with Gran Torino. So, a dark side user kills Obi-Wan's master, Qui-Gon Jinn. Kind of like how All For One kills All Might's master, Nanashimura. Also, notice how similar Nanashimura and Qui-Gon Jinn look, and this is not a coincidence. Of course. Just look at their hair. First of all, that's a damn sexy ponytail. I want it. Secondly, they look so similar. Luke Skywalker ends up fighting Darth Vader, loses a hand, and finds out that Vader is his father. Now, this is the scariest thing. Okay, this is the scariest thing because this could be exactly what happens in My Hero Academia with Deku, given the fact that we're already starting to see the foreshadowing of Deku's hands being hurt and injured continuously. Are things starting to line up for you guys just like they are for me, or what? His hands? Come on. Okay, now, so Izuku's father's name is said to be Hisashi Midoriya. And Midoriya's father is said to be a traveling working man, which in Japan is not uncommon. It's pretty common and happens all the time. The name Hisashi is actually a play on words for a long time ago, which could be hinting to, you know, why he's always away and is a bad father.
People get sad when they don't have their father, man. You need to be there for them. This is just that's sad. That's not good to be kind.
Moving on. So as you can see here, her husband took a work post abroad. She's essentially raising Izuku as a single mother. Okay, so now those are the facts. All For One's injuries would explain why he hasn't returned for so many years, since his battle with All Might, you know, he would not be able to fool Inko Midoriya that he was just a regular guy anymore. Now, Hisashi Midoriya is also said to be a fire user. Now, having a fire quirk, this is completely possible for All For One, because we know his powers, that he can literally take another person's fire power if he needed to. And this is an image from the manga showing Inko Midoriya mentioning what Hisashi Midoriya's powers might be. So she says here, and my husband breathes some fire here and there. Now, some people would automatically think that this could make Endeavor Deku's father. But at this moment, right now, this theory still seems quite far-fetched and not really possible. But All For One being Midoriya's father, this would be quite an ironic plot twist, given the fact that in the sports festival, Midoriya literally puts himself possibly winning the festival on the line to help Shoto Todoroki realize his full potential, which mainly has to do with getting over his fatherly insecurities. And he basically makes Shoto Todoroki, Midoriya makes Shoto realize that he's not bound by his father's legacy, that he is not Endeavor and not Endeavor's legacy. Meanwhile, what if that's the same ironic realization that Deku might be getting set up to face for himself? Now that would be so ironic. Parallels between Tomura Shigaraki and Deku. There could be a parallel where, since Tomura Shigaraki, Nana Shimura's grandson, has become the potential successor of All For One, just as Deku is being groomed to be All Might's successor, but could actually be All For One's son. This concept makes sense because if All For One is Midoriya's dad, it makes sense for him to not have a quirk. Because All For One might possibly have a hand in the quirk of Midoriya disappearing because of All For One's abilities to steal other people's powers. The doctor who said Midoriya was quirkless. Here's some proof. Deku's doctor is the same doctor that is working with and for All For One. Dr. Tsubasa. He's the one who told Midoriya and his mother that they should give up on Deku having a quirk at all. But he could have been lying. If you guys remember this moment. This Dr. Tsubasa is also the grandfather of the kid who was seen to be bullying Midoriya alongside Bakugo when they were younger, if you recall. In My Hero Academia Extra Material, the author himself mentions and brings attention to the fact that the winged Nomu, grabs Deku. It's crazy how Horikoshi's relating things. This kind of reminds me of Naruto, because you know how things would tie back from like 300 episodes before and things like that? It's crazy how Horikoshi's also very good at this. In conclusion, guys, if Torino could be compared to Yoda, and if Izuku is a Luke Skywalker of My Hero Academia, and All Might is Obi-Wan, then what would that mean for All For One? Guys, I'm not afraid to get into details with this one, guys. At the bottom, comment away. I'm down to discuss in detail in the comments. Now, I know at first All For One being Midoriya's father seems ridiculous. To be honest, I don't want it to be true. I just don't want it to be true. But then again, it is Horikoshi, and he has a way of playing with irony. And after all these little pieces of evidence / hints, I'm not sure myself. All For One, Deku's father, is it really possible? Mm-hmm.